काय केलं तू पण हार धवट नुसता.
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. गुड मॉर्निंग मैम. हाजिरा मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम.
मैम वी हैव द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु जॉइन. वी कैन स्टार्ट द सेशन फॉर पेपर वन मैम. 11:30 वी कैन डू पेपर वन एंड 11:30 टू 12:30 पेपर टू.
ओके.
या मैम यू कैन स्टार्ट द सेशन मैम.
ओके मैम. थैंक यू. So very good morning to everyone. Today in this session we are going to cover the logical reasoning part in paper 1. So in logical reasoning we are going to see fallacy and moods and figures. So what is fallacy? A fallacy is the defect in the argument that consists in something other than false premises alone. So fallacy means, in simple word, mistakes or defects. Okay, there are two types of fallacies: formal fallacy and informal fallacy. A formal fallacy is one that may be identified by merely examining the form or structure of the argument. So which means the formal fallacy focuses on the structure of the argument. Okay, then the informal fallacy. Informal fallacies are those that can be deducted only by examining the content of the argument. So which means informal fallacy means examining the content of the argument rather than structure of the argument. Okay, so there are two types of fallacy: formal fallacy and informal fallacy. So formal fallacy focuses on the structure of the argument. Informal fallacy focuses on the content of the argument. So in this we are going to cover the formal fallacies. So before that, we should know the classification of propositions. So there are two types of propositions. So first one, universal, then the second one is the particular. There are two types of propositions, universal and particular. Then universal proposition is further divided into two parts. They are universal positive, then universal negative. So we are using four letters: A, E, I, O. So we frequently see these letters in our net paper. Okay, so A means it is universal positive or universal affirmative. So we are using the alphabet A for representing the universal positive or affirmative. So this one denotes the inclusion. So we are taking one example, all S is P. So in each premise, we are having subject and predicate. So subject appears after the keyword all. So universal affirmative indicated with the keyword all. Okay, so the term appear after the keyword is considered as the subject, then at end of the premise we are having the predicate. So in this example, S is the subject, P is the predicate. Okay, so here example, all cats are animals. So in this one, cat is the subject, animal is the predicate. Then one more important point about the universal passive is it distributes only the subject. Suppose in exams they are given this statement, like this statement, all cats are animals. Then they are asking which one is distributed in the given premise, means the subject only. So which means cat only distributed, not animals. So which is distributed in the given premise? Cat. So cat is distributed. So the universal proposition is divided into two parts: universal positive, universal negative. We are using the letter capital A for representing the universal positive proposition. Then here example, all cats are animals. In this one, subject is the cat, predicate is the animal. Then the universal positive distributes only the subject. So in the given example, cat is the subject, so which means cat is distributed here. So animal is not distributed. Okay, then the next one, it is universal negative. So we are using the letter capital E for representing the universal negative proposition. So this one denotes the exclusion. So the previous one denotes the inclusion, but universal negative denotes the exclusion. Okay, so here we are having one example, no fish are birds. So the keyword for universal negative is no. Then fish is the subject, then bird is the predicate. Then the key property of universal negative is this one distributed both subject and predicate. So which means in the given example, which is distributed? Fish and birds. Okay, then. So the previous one is about the universal propositions. So here we are going to see the particular propositions. So the particular proposition also divided into two parts. So the first one is the particular positive. We are using the letter capital I to denote the particular positive. So universal positive means it is a inclusion. Universal positive means it is inclusion. Particular positive means this one indicates the partial inclusion. So here we are having example, some men are foolish. Here some is the keyword for particular positive. So in this one, men is the subject and foolish is the predicate. So the key property of particular positive is it doesn't distribute subject and predicate. Okay, so here neither the subject nor the predicate. Suppose in exams they are given the statement in particular positive and they ask which one is distributed here means nothing, because it doesn't distribute subject and predicate. Okay, so nothing is distributed. So the next one is particular negative. So particular negative, we are using the letter capital O. So this one denotes the partial exclusion. So universal negative means it is exclusion. So in the case particular negative, it is partial exclusion. So here the example, some bird are not carnivores. So in this one, some not is the keyword for particular negative. The bird is the subject, carnivore is the predicate. Then this one distributes only the predicate. So which means in the given example, which one is distributed? Carnivores. So these things we should know before we are going to fallacy topic. Okay, so the classification of propositions, universal positive, universal negative, then particular positive, then particular negative. So this table is the summarization of the previous two slides. Okay, so the sign A, then statement form, all SRP, example, all politicians are liars. Then here subject is distributed. Then the two more terms related to the propositions concept is quantity and quality. Okay, so these two terms are very important for solving the square of opposition type questions too. So quantity means it is universal positive. So quantity is universal, quality means it is positive. Then the next one, capital E, this is universal negative. The statement form, no SRP, then no politicians are liars. Then, so this is universal, then quality is negative. So this one distributed both subject and predicate. Then the next one, particular positive. So the sign is capital I. The statement form, some SRP, then example, some politicians are liars. Then quantity is particular, quality is positive. Then distribution, neither subject nor predicate. Then the next one is O, so which means this one is particular negative. Then statement form, some S or not P. Then the example, some politicians are not liars. So the quantity is particular, quality is negative, then it distributes only the predicate. Okay. Then the parts of categorical propositions. So there are three parts. The first one is major premise. Then second one is the minor premise. Then conclusion. So these three makes the categorical syllogism. So major premise, minor premise, and the conclusion. So we are deciding the major premise and minor premise according to the conclusion only, because sometimes in exams they are given in different order. Okay, so we can't take anything as major premise or minor premise. So depends on the conclusion only, we should decide which one is the major premise and which one is the minor premise. Okay. So how to identify the major premise? Predicate of the conclusion is called the major term. So for example, So I am giving only example. Okay, here we are having two premises and one conclusion. So I just randomly given one example. Okay, so consider the conclusion. In conclusion, no CRA. So first, look at the subject and predicate of the conclusion. So subject of the conclusion is C. Predicate of the conclusion is A. Predicate of the conclusion is called the major term. Okay, so this is major term. So predicate of the conclusion is called the major term. So which means in the given example, A is the major term. Then the premise containing the major term is called major premise. Okay, which means the term A appears in which premise? In all A or B. Okay, so which means this one is the major premise. Okay, then subject. So next one, minor premise. Subject of the conclusion is called minor term. Okay. So here in the example, subject is C. So this is our minor term. Then the premise containing the minor term is called minor premise. So here the minor term is C. So which premise comprises C? So no B or C. So which means this one is our minor premise. So with the help of the conclusion only, we can decide which one is the major premise and which one is the minor premise. So the predicate of the conclusion is major term. The subject of the conclusion is minor term. Okay. Then the next one is middle term. So middle term means the term common in both the premises, in major and minor premises. So here all A or B, no B or C. So which one is the middle term? It is B. So B is the middle term. So the middle term concept is very helpful in solving the moods and figures type questions. Okay, so these are the basic terms we should know for solving the fallacy type questions and moods and figures questions. So there are three parts of the statements in categorical syllogism: major premise, minor premise, then conclusion. Major premise means the predicate of the conclusion is called major term. So the premise containing the major term is called major premise. Then minor premise means subject of the conclusion is called minor term. The premise containing the minor term is called minor premise. Next, middle term. One term common in both the premises is called middle term. So I hope everyone, what is major premise, minor premise and middle term. So next one, it is the continuation of the categorical propositions only. How we identify the A type propositions, E type propositions, I type propositions and O type propositions. So the A type propositions, the statement starting with the words each, every, any, etc. attribute treated as A type propositions. So we know that A type means it starts with all. So in addition, these words is included in the list. So each, every, any. So any statement start with each, every, any with positive meaning means it is A type propositions only. Okay, then E type propositions. So the sentences beginning with the words like no, never, none. So these are treated as E type propositions. Okay. Then I type propositions, affirmative sentences with words like few, certain, most, and many are treated as I type propositions. Then O type propositions, a negative can sentence that begins with a word like every, any, each, all is treated to be the O type propositions. So here also we are having the keywords each, every, any, but so the sentence giving negative sense means it is O type. The sentence giving positive sense means it is A type. So now we move to the fallacy types. So the first rule, avoid four terms. So a valid standard form categorical syllogism must contain exactly three terms, not four terms. Okay, so here is the example. Every man is a sinner. Raja is the sin man. Then conclusion, Renu is the sinner. Here, man is the one term, sinner is the second term, Raja is the third term, then Renu is the fourth term. But what is the rule here? A valid standard form categorical syllogism must contain exactly three terms, not four terms. So here we are having four terms. So which means here the fallacy of four terms occurs. Okay. Then rule two, distribute the middle term in at least one premise. So distribute the middle term in at least one premise, either major premise or minor premise. So the fallacy is committed on the rule. So this is the second rule. So what are the fallacies committed on the rule? So there are two fallacies committed on this rule. So the first one is the, one fallacy only. So the distributed middle term in at least one premise, the fallacies committed on the rule is fallacy of the undistributed middle. So which means a formal mistake in which the categorical syllogism contains the middle term that is not distributed in either premise. So for example, we are taking this one. The earth is a planet. First, identify the type of propositions. So this is the A type propositions. Then the second statement, the Mars is the planet. So this is also A type. Then the conclusion, the earth is Mars. So this is also A type. Okay, we know that A type proposition distributes only the subject. So in the first statement, which one is the subject? Earth. In the second one, which one is the subject? It is Mars. Then in conclusion, the subject is Earth. So which means in all the premises and conclusion, only the subject is distributed, the earth, Mars, and earth only. Okay. But which one is the middle term here? Planet. So the term planet is not distributed in both premises, in major premise and minor premise. It is not distributed. Because A type propositions distributes only the subject. So here planet is the predicate in both premises. So which means these two are not distributed. But what is the rule here? Distribute the middle term in at least one premise. So at least one premise. Here, no distribution in both premises. So which means here the fallacy of undistributed middle happens. Okay. Then the third one. Rule 3. Any term distributed in the conclusion must be distributed in the premises. So the fallacy is committed on the rule. So there are two types of fallacies committed. The first one is the fallacy of illicit major. Second one, fallacy of illicit minor. So just read the rule. Any term distributed in the conclusion must be distributed in the premises. So that is the rule. So the first fallacy is fallacy of illicit major. A formal mistake in which the major term of the syllogism is undistributed in the major premise, but it is distributed in the conclusion. So that is fallacy of illicit major. So here one example, all cats are mammals. Okay. Then no dogs are cats. Then no ducks are mammals. So first identify the type of proposition. So this one is A type. This one is E type. Then this one also E type. Then identify the subject. So subject is cat, predicate is mammal. Here subject is dog, then predicate is cat. Then here subject is dog, then mammal is the predicate. Okay, so after that, just remember the distribution property of A type and E type. So A type distributes only subject. So E type distributes both subject and predicate. So conclusion also E type means it distributes both subject and predicate. Okay, so after that, remember the structure of the conclusion. I already told that. Predicate of the conclusion is major term. Subject of the conclusion is it is minor term. Okay, in the conclusion, both subject and predicate are distributed, which means dog and mammals distributed. Okay, so first look at the minor term. So the minor term is subject, so that is dogs. So dog is distributed in the conclusion and also in the minor premise, because here both subject and predicates are distributed. So which means here no problem. Okay, then move to the major part of the, which means major term of the conclusion. So here it is mammals. It is distributed in conclusion, but it is not distributed in the premise, because in the premise cat only distributed. So which means this is fallacy of illicit major. Okay, so this is the definition. A formal mistake in which the major term of the syllogism is undistributed in the major premise. So in the major premise, it is not distributed, but it is distributed in the conclusion. So which means here the fallacy of illicit major happens. Okay, then we move to the next one. I already told that rule 3 committed two types of fallacies, fallacy of illicit major, then fallacy of illicit minor. So then fallacy of illicit minor. So we are taking one example. First, identify the type of proposition. It is E type. It is A type. It is also E type. Then identify the subject and predicate. So men is subject. Perfect is predicate. Here men is subject. Then animal is predicate. Then here animal is subject. Then perfect is predicate. Okay. Then remember the distribution property of A and E. So this one distributes both subject and predicate. So this one distributes only the subject. So this one distributes both subject and predicate. Okay. So both subject and predicate means here men and perfect distributed. Only subject means here men is distributed. Then both subject and predicate means here animal and perfect is distributed. Okay, so now come to the conclusion part. So in conclusion part, animal is the subject. So that is the minor term. Okay, then perfect is the predicate. So that is major term. Okay, so I already told that. So the major term means which one is the major premise? This one is the major premise. So the animal is the minor term means. So it is the minor premise. Okay, so here check the animal. Animal is distributed in the conclusion, but it is not distributed in the minor premise. Okay, then which means here the fallacy of illicit minor happens because the minor term, which means the conclusion subject is distributed, but the minor premise predicate, it is not distributed. So which means here the fallacy of illicit minor happens. Okay. Then fallacy types, rule 4, avoid two negative premises. So avoid two negative premises. So here the chance of fallacy of exclusive premise happens. So a formal mistake in which both premises of the syllogism are negative. If both premises are negative, no conclusion follows. So which means if both are negative means no conclusion follows. Okay, sometimes if they are given conclusion means that the fallacy of exclusive premises happens. See here the first one is it is the type O. So this one also type O. So according to the rule, if both premises are negative means no conclusion follows. Okay, but here we are having the conclusion on O. So which means here the fallacy of exclusive premises happens. Then rule 5. If either premise is negative, the conclusion must be negative. So here the fallacy of illicit negative happen. So there is a chance. So which means a formal mistake in which one premise of the syllogism is negative, but the conclusion is affirmative. See here all Americans or not Asians means this is O type. Then all Filipinos are Asians means it is A type. Then the conclusion is all Filipinos are Americans, it is A type. So the formal mistake in which one premise of the syllogism is negative. Here the syllogism one premise is negative, but the conclusion is affirmative here. So which means here the fallacy of illicit negative happens. Then rule 6, from two universal premises, no particular conclusion may be drawn. So this is the 6th rule. So here the committed fallacy is existential fallacy. So as a formal fallacy, the mistake of interfering the particular conclusion from two universal premises. So here the example, all pets are domestic animals, so this is universal affirmative type. Then no lions are domestic animals, so this is universal negative type. So what is the rule here? From two universal premises, no particular conclusion may be drawn. But here the conclusion is the particular negative. So which means here the possibility of existential fallacy committed. Okay. So these are the six rules. So we will see examples. So consider the syllogism below and identify the fallacy involved in it. All pets are domestic animals, no lions are domestic animals. Therefore, some lions are not pets. So there are four options: fallacy of exclusive terms, fallacy of illicit minor, existential fallacy, then fallacy of undistributed middle. Okay. So now we are going to check the options. Okay. So here all pets are domestic animals, so it is A type. No lions are domestic animals, it is A type, which means these two are universal types. But the conclusion is O type, so that is particular. So these two are universal. So which means here the fallacy of existential fallacy committed. So the right answer is it is existential fallacy. Then examine given argument and choose the correct name of the fallacy out of quotes given below. So here the arguments: all horses are four-footed animals, no action or horse, no action or four-footed animal. Okay, so here we are having four quotes: fallacy of illicit major, fallacy of illicit middle term, then fallacy of illicit minor, then none of this. Okay, so this one is the first two are premises. So the third one is the conclusion. Okay, so first identify the type of the proposition. It is A type. Then no action or horse means it is E type. Then no action or four-footed animals means it is E type. Okay, then horses is the subject here, footed animals is the predicate. Here action is the subject, horse is the predicate. Then here action is the subject, then footed animal is the predicate. So just refer the conclusion. So the subject of the conclusion is minor term. Then the predicate of the conclusion is major term. Okay, then remember the distribution property of A and E. So A means distributes only the subject, which means horses is distributed here. Then E means both subject and predicates are distributed, which means action or horse. Then here E type, so which means action and four-footed animals are distributed. Okay, so check it. So the minor term action is distributed, so which means we should refer the minor premise also. So in minor premise also action is distributed. The predicate footed animals is distributed in the conclusion, but it is not distributed in the major premise. So which means here the fallacy of illicit major committed. Okay, then so the syllogism: some lions are friendly, no friendly things roar, therefore no lions roar. So the options are: is a valid syllogism, commits the fallacy of illicit major, commits the fallacy of four terms, then commits the fallacy of illicit minor. Okay, so first we are going to write the given syllogism. So look at the conclusion: no lions or roar. So which means lion is the subject and roar is the predicate. So this is minor term, this is major term. So minor term means the term is lines. Okay, so the line appears in the some lines are friendly. So which means this is our minor premise. Okay, then roar. So roar is the major term. So the major term appears in the no friendly things. Roar. So this is major. So I am writing no friendly things roar. Then some lines are friendly. Therefore, no lines roar. Okay. So we arrange the given statements. Okay. No friendly things roar is the major premise. Then some lines are friendly. So that is minor premise. Then this one is the conclusion. Okay. So no friendly things roar means here the friendly and roar both are distributor because it is E type. Then some lines are friendly. So which means here nothing is distributor because it is I type. Okay, no distribution. Then here no lines are roar means lines and rows both are distributor because it is E type. Okay, so here line is distributor, but in the minor premise line is not distributor. Then here row is distributor, but row is distributor in the major premise. So which means here the fallacy of illicit minor committed. Okay, next. So which of the following fallacies is committed by the argument? All lions are animals, all tigers are animals, all tigers are lions. Then options are undistributed middle, illicit minor, illicit major, then exclusive premises. Okay, then first identify the type of the proposition. A type, then A type. Then identify the subject and predicate in each one. Okay. So in the conclusion, we are having the subject tiger. So that is the minor term. Lion is the major term. So which means all lions are animal is major premise. All tigers are animals is minor premise. Okay. So here lion is distributor, here tiger is distributor, here tiger is distributor. Okay, so in the conclusion only tiger is distributor. Okay, then in minor premise also tiger is distributor, which means there is no problem in the minor term. Then in major term, line is not distributed here. Okay. So, but it is distributed in the major premise. But when the fallacy happens, if it is distributed in the conclusion, but it is not distributed in the premise means. But in the conclusion, line is not distributed, which means no need to check the fallacy of illicit major. Okay. So then there is no possibility for illicit minor and illicit major. Okay, then the next one, exclusive premises. So there is no chance for this also. Then we have to check the undistributed middle. So which means we have to check the middle term. So the middle term is animals. So the middle term animal is not distributed in both premises. So which means here the fallacy of undistributed middle happened. Okay, then the next one. All animals are mortal. All men are animals. Therefore, all men are mortal. So dash is the major term of the above syllogism. So for major term, refer the conclusion. subject is the minor term, then predicate is the major term. So which means here they are asking the major term. So which one is the major term? It is mortal. So the next one, all men are mortal, all kings are men, therefore all kings are mortal. So dash is the minor term of the above argument. So mortal, kings, men, then are. Okay, so in this one they are asking minor term. So minor term means the subject of the conclusion. So which mean king is the subject of the conclusion. So king is the answer here. Then the next one, all men are mortal, Socrates is the man, therefore Socrates is mortal. So dash is the middle term of the above argument. So which one is the middle term here? Men. So the answer is men. Okay, so I hope everyone clear with the concept formal fallacies. Okay, so now we move to the concept moods and figures. So we are having four types of figures: figure 1, figure 2, figure 3 and figure 4. So we are differentiating the figures with the help of the middle term only. So the position of the middle term only can decide the types of the figure. Okay, so the figure of the categorical syllogism is determined by the position of the middle term. Okay, position of the middle term, see here. So look at the major and minor premise and decide it whether this one belongs to figure 1 or figure 2 or figure 3 or figure 4. So in major premise, in subject we are having middle term, and in minor premise we are having middle term. In predicate means it is figure 1. For example, I'm taking random examples only. So all A is B, all C is A. Okay, here subject is A. In subject we are having the middle term because A is the middle term. So likewise in minor premise, so the middle term in the predicate. So which means this one is figure 1. Okay, then the figure 2 means, so the position of middle term in the second figure is predicate. So which means it is the predicate only. For example, all B is A, all C is A. Okay, here the common term, which means middle term, is A. So both occurs in the predicate only. So which means this is figure 2. Okay, the next one is figure 3. Okay, so that is all A is B, all A is C. So middle term is A. So this one occurs in the subject of two premises. So which means this is figure 3. Okay, then figure 4. So figure 4 means it happens in the predicate and subject combinations. So which means all B is A, then all A is C. So A is the common term. So it happens in the predicate and subject combination. So which means this is figure 4. So I am just giving the example only. Okay. So these are the valid moods. So figure 1, the valid moods are Barbara, Dairy, Celeron and Ferio. Okay. So just remember the combination A. So which means Barbara, A, Barbara. Next A, I. So Dairy, A, I. Then E, A, E. So E, A, E means Celeron, E, A, E. Then E, I, O means it is Ferio. Okay, so these are the four valid moods of figure 1. Okay, so mostly they are asking this type of questions in match the following time. Okay, then figure 2. So figure 2 also having four moods. Camstrus, so A, E. Then A, O, Baraco. Then E, A, E, Caesar. Then E, I, O, it is festino. Okay, so these are the four valid moods of figure 2. Then the third one, figure 3. So the valid moods are 6 moods. Okay, so this figure only having highest number of moods. AAI, Darapti. AII, Datic. EAO, it is Phelpton. Then EIO, it is Ferrisson. Then IAI, it is Disamis. Then OAO, it is Bocado. So these are the valid 6 moods of figure 3. Then figure 4 means we are having 5 moods. So AAI, Pramanti. Then AEE, it is Camnus. EAO means it is Fesopho. EIO means it is Precision. Then IAI means it is Dimaris. Okay, so these are the valid 5 moods, valid 5 moods of figure 4. Then exercises. So which one of the following symbolic moods are valid in all 4 figures? So in all 4 figures, we are having EIO, 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 then EIO combination. So which means the right answer is it is EIO. Then which of the following figure hold Bocado as the valid argument? See the moods Bocado. So Bocado in the figure 3. Then both AAA and EIO are valid in which of the following figures? 1, 2, 3, 4. So AAA only available in figure 1. So the answer is figure 1. The next one, which of the following is the true statement? The mood indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. The figure indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. Then quality indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. Then quantity indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. So the right answer is it is the figure indicates the position of the middle term in the premises. Then the fifth question, which of the following figures have highest number of valid moods? So figure 3. So 6 moods now. Next one, according to the traditional logic, the number of valid moods in the fourth figure of syllogism is, it is 5. So then one exercise the combination of fallacy and the moods and figures. Okay. So AEE 1. So here 1 means it refers the figure 1. Then AEE. So we are writing one statement according to the structure of figure 1. Okay. So what is the structure of figure 1? So in figure 1, subject predicate combination. So subject predicate combination. Okay, A means all. So the middle term in the subject, all A is B. Then E means no type. No. Then the middle term in the predicate in the minor premise. So A. So which means no C is A. Then E is the conclusion. No C is B. Okay. So this is AEE 1 format. So here they are asking which type of fallacy committed here. Okay, we check it. So here A only distributed. Here C and A is distributed. Here C and B is distributed. So first we are checking undistributed middle. So the middle term is A. So here the middle term is distributed in both premises. So there is no chance to occur the undistributed middle here. Okay, then we are checking the major and minor. Here C is distributed. Then in the minor premise also C is distributed. So there is no chance to occur illicit minor. Then C here. Here B is distributed, but B is not distributed in the major premise. So which means the right answer is it is illicit major. Okay, then the next one. AAA2. Okay, so which means it is figure 2. So what is the structure format of figure 2? Predicate and predicate. We are taking A model. All B is A, then all C is A. So the middle term in the predicate and predicate combinations. So then conclusion, all C is B. So this is the AAA2 format. Okay. So in this one, B is distributed. In this one, C is distributed. In this one also, C is distributed. So first we are checking the middle term distributed or not. Here A is the middle term, but A is not distributed in both premises. So which means the right answer is it is undistributed middle. Okay. Then the next one, AAA3. So AAA3 means just recall the structure of figure 3. So it is subject and subject combination. Okay, so that is all A is B, all A is C. So the conclusion is all C is B. So this is AAA3 format. Okay, so here A is distributed, here also A is distributed, here C is distributed. See here C is distributed, but it is not distributed in the minor premise. So which means here illicit minor committed. Okay, so I hope everyone understand the concept of fallacies and moods and figures. Thank you all. Paper 1 session is over. Anybody is having query?
Yes, Pankaja Deshmukh. Ma'am, you've raised your hand. Do you have any queries, ma'am? Pankaja Deshmukh, ma'am?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yeah. Anyone else has any queries? For next 2 minutes, we are here for paper 1, and then we shall start with paper 2. I hope everyone is solving the quizlings given by the trainer as well as by our staff. So previous year question papers as well as the topics which have been covered. I've been like the quiz has been sent updated onto the Telegram channel. Okay, ma'am. So paper 1 session is over for the day. Tomorrow we shall start with paper 1 at 10:30 sharp. So ma'am, we can start with paper 2, ma'am.
Ma'am, I need 5 minutes break.
Yeah, ma'am. No worries. After 5 minutes, we will start with paper 2. So be here in the meeting itself. Do not leave the meeting, everyone. Meanwhile, if anyone has any queries or would like to give a feedback, they can unmute themselves and please give the feedback. So you can even post your feedback into the chat box or on the Telegram channel. Someone from the attendees, from the aspirants, if anyone can give away the feedback.
Yes, ma'am, I am posting now.
Yeah. Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, yeah. Just post the feedback link in the chat box as well as the Telegram channel.
Hello everyone, screen is visible.
Yeah ma'am, the screen is visible ma'am.
Thank you ma'am. So in this session we are going to cover the genetic algorithm in computer science. So nowadays in UGC NET, they are asking few questions from this topic too. So what is genetic algorithm? Genetic algorithm is the method for solving both constrained and unconstrained optimization problems based on the natural selection process that mimics the biological evaluation. So genetic algorithm is the optimization based technique. So many researchers are doing research on this topic. So this is one of the hottest topic for research too. Okay, then two distinct elements of genetic algorithm are individuals and populations. So what is individual and what is population? So the individual is the simple solution. Then the population is the set of individuals currently involved in the search process. So we will see the diagram, then you will get the idea. So what is individual? What is population? Okay. So here, this particular bit, the single bit is called gene. Okay, so individual means the whole four bits, it's called individual. So here I am giving example only four bits. It may be any number of bits. Okay, so the particular single bit is known as gene. Then the collection of genes are called individual. Okay, then the population. So the population means the set of individuals. So here we are having four individuals. Okay, then we can say individuals as chromosome 2. So these four individuals makes the population. Okay, so that is the difference. Individual is the simple solution, while the population is the set of individuals currently involved in the search process. So there are five phases considered in the genetic algorithm. So mostly they are asking the MCQs related to that. So they are given the names of the phases and which one is not belong to the genetic algorithm life cycle. So the questions are like that only. Okay, so there are five phases. So the five phases are initial population, then fitness function, selection, crossover, then mutation. So the initial population begins with the set of individuals which is called the population. So each individual is the solution to the problem you want to solve. So already I gave the pictorial representation of what is individual and what is population. Okay, then an individual is characterized by the set of parameters known as genes. So you know what is gene too. Okay, the individual bit. So that is gene. So individual means the set of parameters. So set of parameters means here they specify the genes. Then the genes are formed into the string to form the chromosome. Okay, so this is chromosome. So individual, then in the other name for individual is it is chromosome. In the genetic algorithm, the set of genes of individual is represented using the string in terms of alphabet. So there are many encoding techniques available. The most famous one is binary encoding. So which means we are using the binary values. So which means the strings of ones and zeros are present. Okay. Then the next one is about the fitness function. So the fitness function only determines how fit the individual is. So this is the measurement to know the ability of individual to compete with other individual. Then it gives the fitness score to each individual. We are calculating the fitness score for each individual. Then the probability that the individual will be selected for reproduction is based on the fitness score. So we will see with the example. Okay, so fitness score, we move to the example now. So we are taking one sum. So we are using different functions for calculating the fitness score. It depends on the problem you have taken. Okay, suppose the genetic algorithm uses chromosomes of the form X equal to A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So with a fixed length of 8 genes. So each gene can be any digit. Between 0 and 9. So let the fitness of individual X can be calculated as so f of x is equal to a plus b minus c plus d plus e plus f minus g plus h. Then let the initial population consist of 4 individuals. With the following chromosomes. So the chromosomes are X1 is 6, 5, 4, 1, 3, 5, 3, 2. Then X2 is 8, 7, 1, 2, 6, 6, 0, 1. Then X3 is 2, 3, 9, 2, 1, 2, 8, 5. Then X4 is 41852094. So kindly everyone note this sum. So in this sum they are given the chromosomes form. So chromosome in the form X equal to A B C D E F G H. The length of the chromosome is 8G because the total number of characters present in the chromosomes are 8 only. So this is the fixed one. Each gene can be any digit between 0 and 9. Then they are given the formula for calculating the fitness. So here they are given this formula. A plus B minus C plus D plus E plus F minus G plus H. So this formula varies according to the problem given or problem you have taken in the research. Okay. It is not a fixed one. So in this problem, they are given the fitness function formula is f of x equal to a plus b minus c plus d plus e plus f minus g plus h. Then let the initial population consist of 4 individuals with the following chromosomes. So the chromosome values are x1, x2, x3, x4. Okay. So now I am clear the screen. Then evaluate the, so it is the continuation of the problem. So evaluate the fitness of each individual then arrange them in the order with the fittest first and the least fit last. Okay. So we are taking the first individual. The first individual is X1, 6, 5, 41, 3, 5, 3, 2. Okay. Then the fitness function is f of X1. Then what is the formula? A plus B minus C plus D plus E plus F minus G plus H. So this is the formula. Okay. So here write the corresponding letters above the values. So A means 6, B means 5, C means 4, D means 1, E means 3, F means 5, G means 3, H means 2. Okay, A plus B, so which means 6 plus 5 minus C plus D. C plus D means it is 4 plus 1 plus E plus F means it is 3 plus 5. Then minus G plus H means it, this is 3 plus 2. So 11 minus 4 plus 1, 5 plus 8 minus 5. So 11 plus 8, it is 19 minus 10. So the fitness score is 9 for the first individual. Okay, then for the second individual, X2. So what is the X2 chromosome value? It is 87126601. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, then calculate the fitness of X2. So A plus B means 8 plus 7 minus C plus D means it is 1 plus 2 plus E plus F means 6 plus 6 minus G plus H means 0 plus 1. Okay, 8 plus 1 means it is 9, 1 plus 2 means it is 3, 6 plus 6 means it is 12, then 1. Okay. So here 12 plus 9, it is 21. 21 minus 4, it is 17. So the fitness for, sorry, here 8 plus 7, it is 15. You take it as 1. Okay. So which means here, so 15, 27, 27 minus 4, it is 23. So the fitness score of chromosome 2 is 23. Then X3. So X3 is 2392 1285. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, again we calculate the fitness score of X3. So A plus B means it is 5 minus C plus D means it is 9 plus 2, it is 11. Then plus E plus F means it is 3. Sorry, here minus. Then 8 plus 5, it is 13. Then 8 minus 24. So 8 minus 24, it is minus 16. So the fitness score of the third individual is minus 16. Okay, then likewise, find the fitness score of the individual X4. So the X4 is, it is 41852094. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, so A plus B means it is 5 minus 8 plus 5, 13 plus 2 plus 0, it is 2 minus 9 plus 4, it is 13. Okay, so then the value is here 7 minus 26. It is minus 19. Okay. So I clear the screen now. So the f of x1 value is, it is 9. F of x2 is, it is 23. Then f of x3 is, it is minus 16. Then f of x4 is, it is minus 19. So they, in the question, they are asking, arrange them in order with the fittest first and the least fit last. Okay. So the fittest first means we are choosing the most optimal value. So that is X2, because it is the highest value, 23. So which means X2 is first, then X1, then X3, then X4. Okay. So the order of the individual is X2, X1, X3 and X4. So I hope everyone understand how to find the fitness score. Okay, then the next concept. So after the fitness score, the next one is about the selection. So this is the second phase. So the idea of selection phase is to select the fittest individuals and let them pass their genes to the next generation. So in the previous step, we calculated the fitness value. So according to the fitness value, we are going to select the fittest individuals and let them pass to next generation. Okay. So the two pairs of individuals are selected based on the fitness scores. So the individuals with the high fitness have more chance to be selected for reproduction. Yes. So in the example also, we selected the individuals with high fitness only. Okay. So in the previous example, according to the previous example, So the two pairs of individuals means what combination? X2, X1 and X2 and X3. So there is a possibility to select it. Okay, for the reproduction process. Then the various selection method available. So the various selection methods are. So the various selection methods, Rowlatt, wheel selection, rank selection, then Boltzmann selection, then steady state selection, then tournament selection. So these are the various selection methods available in genetic algorithm. So according to our problem, we can choose the selection methods. Okay. So the next important concept is crossover. It is the most significant phase in the genetic algorithm. For each pair of parents to be mated, a crossover point is chosen at random. So we are choosing the crossover point at random only from within the genes. Okay, so that is crossover. So there are mainly two types of crossover. Then in some papers they are given the arithmetic crossover also. So here I covered that too. Okay, so the single point crossover and the two point crossover. Okay, so the single point crossover means the crossover point on the parent organism string is selected. All data beyond that point in the organism is string is swapped between the two parent organisms. So strings are characterized by the positional bias. Okay, then two point crossover. So two point crossover is the specific case of the end point crossover technique. So in this case, they are we should choose the two random points on the individual chromosomes. Okay, and the genetic material is exchanged at these points. Okay, so I will show you the visual representation of single point crossover and two point crossover. So this is parent one and parent two. Okay. In parent 1, parent 2, the parent 1, I'm using different pattern for representing parent 1 and parent 2. Okay, in single crossover point, I randomly choose a point here. So now, what will be the offspring? So the offspring 1, offspring means children. So beyond this point, the contents are exchanged. Okay. So what will happen? So after that, the contents are swapped. So this is single point crossover. If we are taking the binary values too. Okay, so this is parent 1, parent 2. We set the cross point here. Means what will be the output? So 10 as it is. Then 0, 1, 1. Come here. Then 0, 1. We keep it as it is. Then 1, 1, 0, 1. Come here. So these are the offsprings. So these are parents. Okay, so this is about the single point crossover. So the next one is two-point crossbow, Vanna. So the concept is same only, but here we are choosing two random crossover points. Okay. So for example, so again we are taking two parent. So parent one, parent two. Then we randomly choose two points, crossover points. Okay, the contents after this point and before this point only exchanged. So this content only exchanged in the two-point crossover. So the offspring will be so these contents are same only. So the middle content only exchanged. So this is two-point crossover. Okay. So we will continue with this one with the previous example. So in previous example, so the order of the individual is x2, x1, x3 and x4 now. We are continuing that problem only. So the continuation of that one, perform the following crossover operations. So the first one, cross the fittest two individuals using single point crossover at the middle point. So what is the order? X2, X1, X3 and X4 now. So the first, cross the fittest two individuals. So the fittest two individual is X2 and X1. So what is the X2 individual value? 8712-6601. Then X1 is, it is 6541. 3532. Okay, here we can't choose the cross point randomly because they are given the constraint. Cross the fittest two individual using the single point crossover at the middle point. If they are not mentioning, means you can take any points, but they are mentioning the middle point. So the middle point means this one. So which means the new offspring values are 8712-3532, then 6541, then 6601. So these are the two new offspring values. So here they are asking single point crossover. At the same time, they are given the constraint. So we have to choose the cross point at the middle point only. Suppose if they are not mentioning in the summons, you can take any points. Okay. Now we move to the next one. So with the same problem only. Cross the second and third fittest individuals using the two-point crossover . So the points are BNF. So here they are asking the second and third fittest. So what order we got? X2, X1, X3 and X4. Here they are given second and third fittest means, so this is the second fittest, this is the third fittest. So take the value of X1 and X3. So X1 is 6541 3532. Then X3 is, it is 239212, then 85. Okay. Here also they are given the constraint. So we have to choose the two cross points according to that one. So they are given points B and F. So which means this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay. So the points after B and after F. So these are the two cross points. Okay. According to the problem. So now the new offspring will be X1, 65, keep it as it is. Then 32 also keep it as it is. Then in X3, 23 also. Then here 85 also. We are going to exchange these contents only. So which means here 9212, then 4135. Okay, so these are the new offspring using the two-point crossover. Okay, I hope everyone understand how to find the single-point crossover and two-point crossover. Okay, then we move to the problem. Two more problem for your practice only. Okay, the sum is for single point crossover with crossover point in the middle. What will be the child chromosome for the following two parent chromosomes? So these are the two parent chromosomes. Then they are mentioning the crossover point. It is in the middle. So middle means this one. Okay, because the length of the individual is 6. So the middle means here only. Okay, so which means we are going to swap this content only. So this one becomes 110011, then 100, then 111. Okay. So which means the new child chromosomes are 110011, 100111. Okay. Then the next one. So here the problem is for 2-point crossover with crossover point after second and fourth bit, what will be the child chromosomes for the following two parent chromosome? 110 111 000 00 11. Okay. So here also they are given the crossover point after second and fourth bit. Okay. Second and fourth bit means here. So which means the new offspring value 00 and 01. Okay. So these are the new two child chromosomes value. Okay. So then we move to the arithmetic crossover. The arithmetic crossover operator linearly combines the two parent chromosomes. So the offsprings are created by exchanging the genes of parents among themselves until the crossover point is reached. Okay, so we will see the types of arithmetic crossover with some examples. So there are two types of arithmetic crossover. So the first type is single arithmetic crossover. Then the second type is it is simple arithmetic crossover. So there are two types, single and simple. So for producing the child in this type of crossover, we are using some formulas. So it is something different from the previous two crossover, single point and 2-point. So here we are using the formula to generate the child. Okay, so first one, it is single arithmetic crossover. So in single arithmetic crossover, we are taking P1, so the parent one. So the parent one is X1, X2, so up to Xn. Then parent two means it is Y1, Y2 up to Yn. Okay, which means the first child format. So this is the formula. So all of you noted it. So X1 comma X2 up to AYK plus 1 minus AXK comma XN. For the second child, Y1, Y2 up to AXK plus 1 minus AYK, then YN. Then the important one is A here. So the A value should be lies between 0 and 1. 0 and 1. Okay. So everyone noted this one. So the first child format is X1, X2. Then AYK plus 1 minus AXK comma XN. So this is the single term only. Then second child, Y1, Y2, then AXK plus 1 minus AYK, then YN. Okay, then A value lies between 0 to 1. So now, we move to the problem. So parent 1 and parent 2, parent 1 value is 0.5, 1.0, 1.5, 2.0. Then parent 2 is 0.2, 0.7, 0.2, 0.7. Then the A value is 0.4. Then select the third gene at random using the single arithmetic crossover. So which means here they are given the A value, then they are asking select the third gene. So third gene means this one, 1.5 and 0.2. We are going to choose at random, okay, using the single arithmetic crossover. Okay, first child. So X1 and X2. So X1 is, so name it X1, X2, X3, X4, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4. So X1, first child, X1, X2 na. So X1 means it is 0.5. X2 means it is 1.0. Then we are choosing the third gene only randomly. So which means here only we can apply the AYK plus 1 minus AXK. So AYK, so A value is 0.4 into YK. YK value is 0.2. So 0.4 into 0.2 plus 1 minus A. So 1 minus 0.4 into, so that is XK. So XK value is, it is 1.5, comma, then the X4 value. The remaining terms we have to write as it is. So 2.0. So after multiplication, we will get 0.98, then 2.0. So this is our first child. We follow the same thing for second child too. So second child is equal to, what is the formula for second child? Y1 comma Y2. So Y1 is 0.2, Y2 is 0.7. Then we are choosing the third gene. So which means we should apply the formula AXK plus 1 minus A, YK here only. Okay. So A value is, it is 0.4. Then YK value is, it is 0.2 plus 1 minus 0.4 into XK value is 1.5. Then write the remaining value 0.7. Then after simplification, the second child will be 0.2, 0.7, then 0.72, comma 0.7. So this is the way to find the child in the single arithmetic crossover type. So I hope everyone got it. Okay, then we move to the simple arithmetic crossover. So the simple arithmetic crossover format is, so the first child X1, X2, AYK plus 1 minus AXK, comma, then AYN plus 1 minus A, XN. So this is for first child. Then second child, Y1, Y2, so up to A, XK plus 1 minus A, YK, comma, A, YN plus 1 minus A, YN. So this is for second child. Okay. So here also we are taking the same problem and try to find the answer. So P1 is 0.5, 1.0, 1.5 and 2.0. P2 is 0.2, then 0.7, then 0.2, then 0.7, then A value is 0.4. Okay, so we are taking the formula for first child, then number it x1, x2, x3, x4, here y1, y2, y3, and y4. Okay, we are taking the same 13 only. Then 0.5, then 1.0. Then we are choosing this one now. So which means we have to apply the formula AYK plus 1 minus AXK. Okay, so AYK plus 1 minus AXK already we found in the previous one. It is 0.98. Yes. Then now the extra addition is the YN part, which means the last part also here having the formula. So AYN plus 1 minus AXN. Okay. So A means it is 0.4 into YN means it is 0.7 plus 1 minus A means it is 1 minus 0.4 into XN means it is 2. So which means 0.4 into 0.7. So 0.4 into 0.7. So that is 0.28 plus. So this is 0.622. So it is 1.2. So 1.2 plus 0.28 is it is 1.48. Which means the last one is 1.48. Okay, then the next one for the second child. So for the second child, Y1 and Y2. So that is 0.2 and 0.7. Okay, then the formula is AXK plus 1 minus AYK. So it is the previous one. Previous one we got 0.72. Now the addition is the XN part only. So the AXN plus 1 minus AYN. So AXN means XN value is 2. Then 1 minus 0.4 into YN value is 0.7. Okay. Then 0.4 into 2 it is 0.8. 0.8 plus 1.04. So it is 0.6. Then 0.6 into 0.7 means it is 0.42. So add the 0.42 into 0.8. So the answer is it is 1.22. Okay, so these are the two types of arithmetic crossover. Okay, so the next one, we move to the next phase. The next phase is offspring. Offspring means here the children. So the children are created by exchanging the genes of parents among themselves until the crossover point is reached. Then the next important one is mutation. In certain new offspring formed, some of the genes can be subjected to the mutation with a low random probability. So this implies that some of the bits in the bit can be flipped. Okay, so here I am giving example for that too. So in which situation we have to do the mutations? It is not necessary in all times. It is necessary in few occasions only, mutations. Okay, so for example, so if you are taking two identical parents means, so the parent one and parent two, okay. So the parent one is 1001011. Then another parent also 1001011. Then we are doing the crossover. So after crossover, the child offspring one and offspring two is same only. So this one caused the premature convergence. For avoiding the premature convergence, we are using the mutation, which means we have to flip some bits. Okay, so we are flipping this bit. So here instead of 0, we are changing 1. Then here instead of 0, we are changing to 1. So like that only, a small amount of mutation. Okay, because this one only prevent the premature convergence. Okay, so what is premature convergence? So the genetic algorithms convert converge too early to suboptimal solution. So as the population evolves, only a little new can be produced. So that is premature convergence. So the reasons for premature convergence are, so the first one, improper selection. Then second one, insufficient population size. Then third one, deception. Then fourth one, improper representation and genetic operators. So these are the reasons for occurring the premature convergence. For avoiding this one, we are using the concept mutation. Okay. Then the next one is the termination. So this is the last step in the genetic algorithm life cycle. So the termination means the algorithm terminates if the population has converged. So which means, which does not produce the offspring which are significantly different from the previous generation. But if you are getting the same offspring within single step, means it is the premature convergence. Okay, so the population has converged, so two or more generations. Okay, then it is said that the genetic algorithm has provided the set of solutions to our problem. Then the encoding. So this is the very first step in the genetic algorithm before all the five phases. Okay. So encoding means it is the process of representing the individual genes. So we are using different types of encoding, binary encoding. So in binary encoding, every chromosome is the string of bits 0 or 1. So for example, if we want to represent 1 means we are using 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, then 5 means we are representing 0101. So this is binary encoding. Then the next one is about the value encoding. So this is the second type. So it is used in problems where values such as real numbers are used. So the previous one is about only the binary numbers 0 or 1. Sometimes we are using the real numbers too. So that time we are using the value encoding concept. So the examples for value encoding means, so it is accepted the real numbers. So I am taking the chromosome A means 1.2324, then 5.3243, then 0.4556. So this is acceptable in value encoding. So the one more example, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. So this is also accepted in the value encoding. So one more examples, then the objects. So left, right, back, forward. So these also accepted in the value encoding. Okay, then the next one is the permutation encoding. So it is used in the ordering problems. So the permutation encoding is used in the traveling search person problem. Okay, so the example for permutation encoding is the chromosome A and B. So we are ordering the number. So the position according to the position. So first position, fifth position, third position, second position, sixth position, fourth position, seventh position, ninth position, eighth position. Here we are arranging the value according to the some orders. So this is permutation encoding. Then the next one is tree encoding. So it is used mainly for evolving programs or expressions. Okay, so we are taking one expression plus into bracket is what close. How we represent this one in the tree encoding method? So the first one is plus symbol. So after that, we are having int mark. Then within the parenthesis, we are having slash. Then in class, after class, we are having x and y. So in this way, we are representing the expressions. Okay, then. So all the topics are covered in the genetic algorithm. I hope everyone understand. If anybody having queries, you can ask. Ashita ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. All the dear participants, today if anyone has any queries, you can raise your hands. And you can unmute and you can ask your queries. Does anyone has any queries? Shivani ma'am, you have raised your hand. Do you have any query? Yes, ma'am. Shivani ma'am, Akshara ma'am. Ma'am, you can unmute and ask your queries, ma'am. Akshara ma'am, are you there? Akshara ma'am? Shivani ma'am? Yeah, just a minute, ma'am. I'll just see, ma'am. I have disabled the mic, so let me check with the things here. Just 1 minute, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, allow kiya hai, ma'am, abhi.
For 2 point crossover with cross point after second and fourth bit, what will be the child chromosome? You explain or no, ma'am? That is only second. What is the meaning, ma'am? Will you able to explain that again, ma'am? Second.
So after the second and third point only, after the second and fourth point only, the contents are exchanged, ma'am. So the remaining things before the second point and after the fourth point remains unchanged.
That is two bits will be called as because we exchanged the third and fourth bit, no, ma'am?
In which one, ma'am?
You explained that in a PPT. Third and fourth bit only.
No, it is about 2 point crossover or arithmetic crossover?
It's about a single point crossover after that, ma'am.
So in single point crossover, after that in the 2 point crossover, madam. So in 2 point crossover, see here. So it is 6541 3532.
Crossover formula.
Okay, ma'am. So then the second individual is 239212, then 85. Now, so the constraint given here is points B and F. Okay, so this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H.
Volume is very low.
Am I audible to you, madam?
Ma'am, it's not.
Yes, ma'am. This we understood, ma'am. The numbers, ma'am. 001111.
Wait, ma'am. I will explain that too also. Okay. So after B and F means after B and F, we are exchanging the content. So this one becomes 9212 6532, then this one 2341 35, then 85. So this is for the number. Then you are asking about the zeros and ones, the binary encoding method. So 110111, then 10001. So in that problem, they are given after the second and fourth point. So after the second means, so this is the second bit. So after the second bit and fourth bit means, so third and fourth. So this one. Okay, then we are exchanging the content in between.
Then why interchange the values?
Because crossover means we are interchanging the content of the genes, ma'am. Then only we can produce the new children.
Only two values?
Yeah, according to the sum, they are given to change only the bits after second and fourth. So they are asking that only. So they are given some constraint. So if they are not given the constraint, means you can take any values. So as per your wish. But in the sum, they are asking which crossover points after the second and fourth bit.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Is it clear to Akshara, ma'am?
Yeah, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Then Shivani, ma'am, is it clear to you?
Yes, ma'am, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
And formula, please repeat.
What, ma'am?
Formula.
Formula. We'll send in Telegram group the formula alone, ma'am.
Okay, okay.
Okay.
Yes, dear audience, anyone has any other queries, please raise your hands. Shivani, ma'am, you have some doubt?
Formula, please, bus formula doubts.
Yeah, ma'am, is the doubt clear?
Yes, ma'am, she's asking the formula. So I told her to send the formula in Telegram group.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. So I don't we will just close the today's session, and tomorrow we shall meet at 10:20 with the same link. And if anyone has any queries, you can post your queries in the Telegram channel. Ma'am is already there. She will help you out in solving your queries. So today's session is over. So tomorrow we shall meet at 10:20. Please fill up the feedback form link and even the quiz. Solve the quiz. Two links have been posted daily. One is by the trainer and one is by the college staff. So ma'am, shall we end up the meeting?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all the audience.
Thank you, ma'am.